Ozempic or Wegovy is a prescription designed to treat type 2 diabetes and is getting lots of attention for one of its side effects, weight loss. Because spoiler alert, it does cause weight loss, and with over 320 million views on TikTok just on Ozempic, this has caused many people who don't have diabetes to use it as an off-label for weight loss, causing the FDA to classify Ozempic and Wegovy injections of semaglutide underneath a shortage. And since this product has gone so viral, especially here in Los Angeles where I'm in, I decided to make an in-depth guide on Ozempic and Wegovy injections of semaglutide and everything you need to know about this product in one video. Also, I'll be sharing with you my number one tip that you should keep in mind to make sure that the weight doesn't come back on when you stop. Also, timestamps are down below too, so check them out as well. But I definitely recommend watching the entire thing to not miss out on the details. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I'd love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like this type of content, then consider subscribing as well. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get straight into what is semaglutide. Semaglutide is an injectable glucagon-like peptide 1 agonist, or short for GLP-1 agonist, that's administered once a week. And it was originally approved in 2017 under the brand name Ozempic to control blood sugar in type 2 diabetes. But something incredible happened. They found that not only did it help control blood sugar, it also led people to lose weight. So the manufacturer wanted to study semaglutide in people who didn't have diabetes at a higher dose to see if they can find any weight loss benefits. And what do you know? Novo Nordisk, the manufacturer, got their product semaglutide FDA approved for weight loss under a new brand name called Wegovy. And ideally, it was made for adults whose BMIs are greater or equal to 30 or 27 with at least one of the following conditions: high blood pressure, high cholesterol, or having diabetes. But how on earth does something that controls blood sugar help you fit into a smaller pair of jeans? And how can it really trim your waistline? Ozempic and Wegovy are GLP-1 receptor agonists, and to simplify that to English, they mimic a natural hormone in the body called incretin. You see, whenever we eat, our digestive tract releases hormones called incretins. That's the normal process of digestion, and not everyone has the same levels of incretins that get released after a meal, which becomes an issue. And the job of incretin is to lower your blood sugar by triggering insulin release and blocking sugar production. And interestingly, it also slows down how quickly food leaves your stomach, which is called gastric emptying. And the slower food leaves your stomach, the longer it is that you feel full, which in turn lowers your appetite and causes you to lose weight. And not only does it lower your appetite, it curbs those feelings of hunger, and it also lowers the amount of food you eat as well, which is why you'll notice feeling full a lot faster and not being able to finish your plate once you're on the medication. The reason for that is because GLP-1 is giving your brain the I'm full signal, so no more Oreos. Semaglutide is available as a single-use injection pen. So basically this means that your dose is already preset for you and you can discard the pen after you inject it, which is once a week on the same day of each week. And it doesn't matter what time of day or if you want to do it with or without food, but just make sure that if you choose Mondays, you stick to Mondays. A pro tip here is also to make sure that you rotate the injection spot because you don't want to be injecting it into the same spot each time. The same body part is fine though, so if you like to stick with the thighs, you could stick with the thighs. And you'll notice that Wegovy is available in slightly higher doses. You got 0.25 milligrams, 0.5, 1 milligram, 1.7, and 2.4 milligram pens, each in different color pens to help keep track of how far you are. Both of them start at the same amount of 0.25 weekly and then gradually increase every month. The only difference is that with Wegovy, you ramp up to a higher sustained dose of semaglutide at 2.4 milligrams per week, which means that when you reach the target dose with Wegovy, which is at the 2.4 milligram per week, the semaglutide here provides superior weight loss as demonstrated by this phase 3 study. Let's look at some side effects, because every month as your dose gradually increases, your chances of experiencing side effects increase as well. For some, reaching that target dose of 1 milligram or 2.4 milligram can be difficult, and your doctor may want to slow things down by waiting another month before they increase your dose, just because the side effects can be quite really annoying. This includes like burping more frequently, nausea, having constipation or diarrhea, headache, dizziness, and feeling bloated. These are all those common side effects your pharmacist will let you in on. And although rare and not a lot of people mention this, but do let your healthcare provider know right away if you are experiencing any changes in mood or behavior. For some, they might not recognize that as a big deal, but it is a good thing to keep note of, especially with side effects that can change your mood. Also on that note, from the 2022 studies like other GLP-1 agonists, semaglutide does increase pancreatic lipase and the risk for pancreatitis, which is why it should not be used if you have a history of chronic or idiopathic acute pancreatitis. To get the most results on Ozempic, Wegovy, or even Saxenda, if you want to be super successful with these, you want to create and eat a healthy and balanced diet. Some foods to avoid include your fried foods, foods and drinks that are high in sugar, processed foods, and of course your fried foods. You want to try your best to limit them, at least, because I know the word avoid can be arbitrary. So if you can limit them as much as possible, then you can get even more benefits out of your medicine. Because they may or may not go through this with you, the calorie limit at the doctor's office, but 2,000 to 2,500 calories a day, depending on your energy demands, seems to be the typical starting point. But it's not just the calories that matter. It's also the nutritional content of your calories. So try to increase your protein-rich foods, and I'll leave a good list here that you can refer to, your vitamin-rich fruits and vegetables, and your whole grains. Wegovy starts working right after you inject a dose, and as far as weight loss, you may see the results within the first 4 weeks, because it has to take some time to build up in your system. I mean, yes, the study did look at it over a 68-week period and found that an average of 35 pounds or 14.9% of body weight was lost compared to placebo, which volunteers only lost 6 pounds, roughly 2.4% of their weight with the placebo, which is a lot of weight. So no, you don't have to wait till the 68-week mark to see the results. But what you do have to expect is that the results will vary from person to person, depending on the weight that you start at when you first take it. Some can lose a few pounds just from going up to the next dose, that's 0.5. And this is where the diet comes in, because depending on what you're eating and your physical activity, you may notice that you lose 5 pounds faster than someone else who's on it and is making poor lifestyle choices. Wegovy costs around $1,300 a month, and most insurance won't cover it. And if they do, insurance companies push back against coverage for weight loss medicines, because their argument is that being overweight or obese is not a disease, but a behavioral problem. So whether it's due to cost, shortages, or if, let's say, you lost all the weight you needed to lose because you had a weight loss goal in mind and you hit that mark, congratulations, because really that's a big deal and you've come a long way, so you should be proud of yourself. One thing you have to know is that the weight might come back on after you stop taking it, because now you don't have the I'm full signal getting to the brain, which will then cause you to start feeling hungrier again. And some have complained that it made them feel even more hungrier than ever before when they were not on it, and more so when it's fully out of your system, which takes around 5 to 7 weeks after you stop for it to leave your system. So it lasts about a month or two after you stop taking it. And the best way to make sure the weight doesn't come back on is to mimic the GLP-1 signal that was already taking place when you were on Ozempic, Wegovy, or Saxenda. And how do you do that? one of the most powerful ways is to start eating slower. Not only will this help you chew your food more and improve digestion, but you tap into another hormone signal that I think is just as beneficial as GLP-1, but doesn't get the full attention it deserves. One example is cholecystokinin, or CCK, which is released by the intestines in response to eating a meal. Another hormone is called leptin, and it's produced by fat cells that communicates with the brain about long-range needs and satiety. Research suggests that leptin amplifies the CCK signal to enhance the feeling of fullness in your belly. Other research suggests that leptin also interacts with the neurotransmitter dopamine in the brain to create pleasure after eating, which is attributed to why certain foods make you happy. So by eating too quickly or too fast, the idea is you're not giving the hormonal crosstalk system enough time to work and communicate with each other. Since it takes 20 minutes for your brain to get the message from your stomach that it's full. Click the red subscribe button down below if you found any value in this, and I'll see you on the next one.